My name is Gerald Mambo. When I die, I want to be remembered for quite a few things. In my corporate life, I want to be remembered as a good team player, a good leader, a great leader, actually. Someone that made the right decisions for his company, for his team, for his employees, etc., etc. I value myself on being a great team player, so that's obviously something very important to me. That's something I want to sort of leave behind within my workplace. And in my personal life, I want to be remembered as someone who is an incredible friend, a great brother, a great son, a great father, a great husband. All these things are like very integral to who I am. I've always valued family and those close relationships to me. So I want to be remembered as someone who kept a great balance throughout his life, who managed to achieve a lot of great things. And I'll never ever attempt to say that, you know, I did things on my own, because that's not how life works. But I want to be remembered as someone who took advantage of every opportunity they were given, who never compromised on who they were, and ultimately added value to everyone's life around them. It feels quite surreal being a graduate, I must say. When I finished writing that exam that I needed, I sort of felt myself. I was like, nah, I know I did what needed to be done here, given the amount of like time and effort I put into studying. And I just felt like, nah, here I've secured my degree. But obviously, it was still great seeing, you know, that little message that says you completed your qualifications for the degree, qualifications obtained, etc., etc. It felt surreal, I must say. Advice I'd give to current students and first years is to make sure you allocate enough time every day, or if not every day, at least every week, just to go over what you've done, and you know, just to refresh your notes, add anything that you've learned throughout your time, throughout talking to your friends and your lecturers as well. I think it's important to stay on top of your work, because the last thing you want to do is, you know, think, okay, I've done enough, and then you get to test week and you quickly realize that you haven't actually done enough, because that is the worst thing. So yeah, I'd recommend stay on top of your work. Make sure you go over your work at regular intervals. Also, you know, make use of your friends. Study together, share notes, bounce ideas off of each other and everything. And by that I mean, if you understand the topic in a specific way, talk to them about it, see if they have a differing understanding of it, and you know, see if you can consolidate from there. I know that's what I did with a few of my friends for quite some time, actually, and it proved very fruitful. So yeah, that's what I recommend you do. Getting to graduation, I think what got me here was just sheer willpower, if I'm honest, because this was quite it's a special environment. It is indeed, and I'm glad that I'm done with it. I'm glad that I went through everything, but ultimately I don't think I would have gotten here if I hadn't thought of the end goal in mind. So you know, when courses peak, right, you know, when things were looking a bit dire, I kind of sat down and said to myself, okay, this can't happen. I need to move forward. I need to, you know, progress faster. But how am I going to? What's there for me afterwards? And ultimately, I set a personal goal for myself. I wanted to get into a specific business school that required obtaining qualification. They accepted me on grounds that I got my degree. So I said to myself, by hell or by high water, I am getting this degree. And you know, that's what got me through. Sheer willpower, having an end goal in mind, and saying to yourself, I am not negotiating, this is gonna happen, I'm making this happen, by hell or high water, I am getting my degree, or I am passing. Do you get what I mean? So yeah, I think that sheer willpower obviously gives you an impetus to now sit down and study, and obviously put in the extra hours, etc., etc. Yeah, I think that was the biggest thing that got me here. I think the most challenging part of getting my degree had to have been the June exams in 2020, simply because, you know, exams are online. We didn't quite know what to expect. We weren't quite ready for it. I wouldn't say we weren't ready for it. I wasn't ready for it. But yeah, it was a lot to deal with in getting those results. It was a shell shock. It was not a great time. I kind of had to, you know, pick myself up and kind of say, you know, let's get this done. And what really helped me through it, I think, as much as, and as I previously said, you know, how important willpower is, I think having that willpower, having goals in mind that I can work towards, and simply, you know, a good support structure, I think those three things really made a difference to me. Because, like, when we were allowed back on campus, two of my closest friends, Tabo and Mingo, we all kind of agreed, listen, now that libraries are open from now until exams, we are going to Wits every day. When the library opens, when the library closes, we are there Monday to Friday. We are working. And then Saturday, work at home. Sunday, you know, do what works for you. But we said Monday to Friday, we are doing this. And I think those guys really helped me a lot. I think as much as I, you know, had prepared, as much as I had my big file of notes, I think having them there, having that energy surrounding me, that positive energy, it made a huge difference. It really did. I wanted, for the first time in a long time, I think for the first time ever, I was looking forward to going to Wits. You get what I'm saying? So that those two made a world of difference. And like when I got my degree, the first thing I said to him was, thank you. Like I genuinely couldn't have done this without you. I don't think I could have done this without you. So I think having that support structure alongside your preparation is priceless. If I was to start again for first year, what would I do differently? I think I'd definitely be a bit more, well, a lot more diligent, and, you know, going to class, attending tuts, etc., because at the very start, because I'd taken accounting in high school, by the time we got to, you know, to first year, everything we're doing, I'd already done in high school, so I thought to myself, I don't need to go to class. I mean, sure enough, I didn't, because I knew it. So I think what I would have done differently is said to myself, okay, I know this stuff really, but I don't know everything else. I don't know e-codes. I don't know information systems. Okay, information systems is quite easy. But, you know, things like that where I haven't done this before, so let me apply myself, let me take the time and actually learn. There were a few times where, you know, I'd give myself multiple days off in a week and say to myself, I don't want to go today. And you know, I feel like that ended up hurting me quite a bit. I definitely think my marks would have been a lot better had I not done that, had I been a lot more diligent and disciplined. But I mean, at the end of the day, I'm here, I've got my degree, you know what I'm saying? But yeah, I definitely go back. I'd be a lot more diligent. I wouldn't go onto campus with board games instead of books. There was a brief period. I think we did that. My friends and I did that for an entire block. So yeah, I definitely do those few things differently. But all in all, I had a lot of fun in first year. It was my first taste of, you know, freedom, in the sense that I don't necessarily have to go to class all day, every day. And I enjoyed that. I enjoyed the freedom. I enjoyed socializing. I enjoyed everything that comes along with, like, the varsity experience kind of thing. So I wouldn't change any of that. I just changed the way I use my free time. Yeah. I have failed an important exam. My first time around doing second year, I failed, I think I failed about three subjects. Was entirely my fault, because I mean, I just wasn't studying, I wasn't putting the time in. Then by the time the exams came around, it was a case of like writing Monday, gap, Thursday, Friday. And you know, there just wasn't enough time to study for those things properly or for those subjects properly. So I did fail them. And when I took them again, I kind of said to myself, okay, listen, it happened once. I'm going to allow myself that, because I mean, it happens. People fail all the time. No one's like, yes, I full applaud and full credit to people who, you know, who get in record time. But you know, people do fail. It happens. So So I just dusted myself off and I said, you're not failing again, plain and simple. And sure enough, I didn't. I really didn't. I managed to put the time and managed to come out best. And I'm happy and I'm proud of myself for handling it the way I did. I think having parents that understood as well and that kind of said to me, it's not the end of the world, it's fine. It happens. So I think that definitely played a huge role. It definitely helped quite a bit. But yeah, ultimately just saying to myself, you failed, it's fine, it happened. Bounce back, don't let it happen again. You're in control now. Yeah, that's how I bounce back. Studying during a pandemic. This is a toughie. This is a big toughie. I think what I'd advise you do is, you know, set up your week. Because you're studying online and everything, it's all up to you. It's all in your time. And obviously because you don't have your tutors or your lecturers there that you can like talk to, you know, when you don't quite understand something, you don't have that person that can like tailor the understanding to you in a specific situation, at any given time. It obviously isn't the same. It impacts the way you learn, the way you study. So what I'd advise you do is make sure you allocate your time. Make sure you get your studying done and your new content done at the beginning of the week. If you can, try to get it done by like Monday, Tuesday, maybe half of Wednesday. Get it done. Get it out the way. I think it's very easy to say that because I was only taking two subjects this year. I was taking Mandarin and Auditing because I passed accounting. I just didn't want to do tax. So I was doing those two this year. And, you know, there's ample time for that. So first things first, get your new work. Again, get it out the way. Then make sure you do your tuts. And attempt your tuts. Be honest with yourself in attempting them. I'll be honest with you, the first one or two scenes, I kind of work with it, with the memo next to me or near me, so that if I get to a point where I don't quite understand, given the notes I've made and the videos I've watched, I'll just refer to it and say, okay, I see how that works. Last unseen, well, the last scene, do it as if it's an unseen, and then the unseens do them as, you know, as they are, to probably test yourself and test if you understand the work that's going on. Another big thing, is, working with those that you have near you, you know what I'm saying? Like I said in the beginning, a little earlier on, that, you know, having friends to bounce ideas off of, that's a huge thing. And that helps a lot right now, because one of your friends could very easily understand the work really well, and you don't have that lecturer or that tutor that you can talk to in real time. Whereas a friend, you can call and say, my man, can I talk to you quickly? If they can, then you say, I don't understand what's going on. Please pull up this unseen. Can you just help me quickly? And spend maybe, what, like 10 minutes on the phone, if even that much. And, you know, from there, you can still gain an understanding. You can still get that assistance you need. But ultimately, it comes down to, you know, to working hard, to putting the hours in. If I show you, let me get this file. This is my file for Mandarin that I use to prepare for exams. This big thing is literally just pages and pages and pages and pages of work. And I mean, it was a lot. This is a lot of stuff, given that these are all notes. You know what I'm saying? These are all notes. These are from the textbook pages I've like kept. So now that I've graduated, I've officially said goodbye to Wits. I am no longer a Wits student. I'm a Wits alumni now. You know what I'm saying? But I'm doing postgrad. I'm doing a postgraduate diploma in business administration at the Gordon Institute of Business Science. They're the best business school in Africa, actually, and they're ranked 32 in the world. So they're very, very reputable. It was quite a stringent process applying, doing all the entrance tests and everything. But thankfully, I've been accepted. So I'm going to be spending the next year at that business school. And the whole point of it is it's a stepping stone towards an MBA. And ultimately, I see myself doing a doctorate in business administration. I have a passion for, you know, for working with people, for, you know, making value-adding decisions. Ultimately, I see myself as being someone who's in a position to make value-adding decisions for a company, for an entity. Not to say that I want to do that alone, far from. I just want to be the person who is part of those that are in the driver's seat. I want to be part of executive management. So that's where my passion lies. I think accounting was a great degree that helped me build towards that. You know, even though halfway through I kind of said to myself, I don't want to be a CA. It's not who I am. It still helped a lot in building my understanding of like assets and liabilities, of business practices, and building my business acumen as well. So the next year is purely dedicated to saying, okay, I alongside being an accountant, I'm going to develop myself into being a capable manager. Over the next year, I'm going to be at Gibbs, postgraduate diploma in business administration. I'm really looking forward to it. I really, really am. It's the first time in a long time that I felt excited about entering an institution and learning, learning with people, with other people, and people who specifically share similar ideas to me. Because even though we're all studying accounting, some people wanted to be CA, some people wanted to be tax consultants, some people wanted to be auditors. Do you get what I'm saying? Whereas in this very, it's a very small class, actually it's a tiny class. In this very small class, we all have the same kind of end goal. We all have not necessarily similar mindsets, but we're all willing to assist and equip each other with knowledge, knowing and understanding that we all want to build our business acumen, and we all want to be part of executive management in the end.